Hello guys, Vivek here. Today in this video we will be talking about how to measure reactive power using wattmeter. Now let us see how we can do that. Now what is reactive power? Let me first write it. What is reactive power? So what is the reactive power? We know Q is equal to VI sine phi, where phi is the angle between V and I. Okay, it is the angle between the voltage and current that we are measuring. So by 2 watt meter method, what we do basically is that we measure the active power. Okay, we measure the active power, but we can actually measure reactive power using watt meter connection, and today in this video we will see how we can do that. Now let me first show you what is the connection that you need to do. Let me first show you how we measure the active power. For an active power measurement, what we would do is that, let's say this is the current coil of the wattmeter. Okay, a wattmeter has two coils, as you know, a current coil and a potential coil. Now the current coil is connected in series, whereas let's say this is the common phase and this is again another phase. Okay, so we connect the current coil in series, while the potential coil, it goes something like this. Okay, and it comes here, and same thing we do here also. This is the potential coil and it goes here. Finally this line is going to three phase load. Okay, this is our load. So this is how we connect to watt meter for measuring three phase power, and the power that we get from here is root 3 VI cos phi. Okay, that is the active power. Now how we can measure three phase reactive power, what should be the connection? So let us first see what connection we need to do. So here, in instead of 2 watt meter, for measurement of reactive power only 1 watt meter is enough, and the rest we need to do is mathematics. Let us see how we can do that. So this is our current coil. We connect the first phase directly through the current coil like this. Okay, and the potential coil which is there, let's say this is the two phases. Okay, the first phase is directly connected through the current coil, and our potential coil is connected like this. This is our potential coil between two phases. Okay, so the measurement now we'll be getting from the wattmeter. This is our wattmeter element. So the thing that we will be getting from the wattmeter will be our reactive power. Okay, this is our load. Okay, so this connection helps us to find the reactive power in one phase. For three phase, what do we do is just that, let's say this W is the reading of our wattmeter, so we need to do root 3 W R, and this is the reactive power. Okay, reactive power is denoted by Q. Active power is denoted by P. Now let us see what is the underlying theory behind this. Now to understand how this circuit works, or how it helps us to measure the reactive power, we need to see the phasor representation of the three phase voltage. So how does it looks like? The three phases are 120 degree apart. Okay, let's say this is R phase voltage VY, this is VB. Okay, three phase voltages. Now let us remind the what was our circuit. The current coil was in series with the R phase, so it was carrying the IR amount of current, while the voltage coil or the potential coil, it was common in between these two voltages. Okay, that is VY and VB. So what we are getting from the potential coil, it is VY minus VB. Okay, so the current that we are getting is IR, and the voltage that we are getting from the wattmeter is VYB. And what will be the angle? The power factor will be between VYB and IR. Okay, so let us see how this works. Now the voltage was VYB, so first of all we need to take VYB. So VB is in this direction. For VYB, VYB is what? What is our VYB? It is VY minus VB. So we need to take the negative direction of VB. So we will take it here. this is R minus VB, okay, along this direction. Let me write it minus VB. Now this is VY and minus VB. If we take the resultant now, so the resultant will be like this, okay. I'm not drawing it to the scale, it's just for representational purpose, okay. You can check it out by drawing it to the scale, okay. Now what is the angle between these two? This is 90 degree. How? Because VB, if you see, what is the angle of VB? It is plus 120 degree with respect to VR. VR is at 0 degree angle, okay, and VB is at plus 120 degree. If you see, it is at plus 120 degree. Now if it is at plus 120 degree and VY is at minus 120, so if you rotate it along this direction, so this is going to be 60 degree. Why? Because VB and minus VB are 180 degree apart. So if this is 120 degree, that means VB is at 60 degree from VR, okay, and VY is already minus 120 degree from VR. So the resultant that is going in between VY and VB, it will be 90 degree with respect to VR, okay. Now iterate the current. Now let us consider that the load is a lagging load, okay. So we need to take the IR, that is the current through phase R. So it will be lagging to VR. It will be something like this. Okay. This is our IR. Okay. This is IR. Now, this is IR and this is our VYB along this direction. Now, what is the angle between VR and IR? Definitely, it's the power factor angle. That is phi. Okay. This is phi. And as this is 90 degree, this angle is 90 degrees. So what is this angle? This is 90 minus phi. 90 minus phi. Okay. So the angle between VYB, the angle between VYB and IR is 90 minus phi. So let me write this again. So we are getting from wattmeter VYB into IR. And the angle between both VYB and IR is cos 90 minus phi. Okay, this is what will be measured from the wattmeter, because wattmeter gives us the active power, but we are reconnecting it for getting the reactive power. Now what is this VYB? VYB is line voltage, okay, and IR is of course the line current IL, and cos 90 minus phi is nothing but sine phi. So in this way we are getting the reactive power of one phase. This is just for one phase, that it is VI sin phi. For getting the three phase, let me write it here. So this is how we get three phase reactive power. This is root 3 VI sin phi, where V and I is line voltage and line current. Okay, so what we need to do, let me remind you again, we will have to connect the current coil directly, whereas the voltage coil is connected in between two phases, okay, like this. So the voltage that we get is VYB, the current that we are getting is IR. IR goes through here, whereas VY and VB is this one, okay, and it can be connected to three phase load. So the power that will be measured by the wattmeter will be reactive power. So I hope this video was quite helpful for you, and if you have liked this video, please share your feedback in the comment section. If you have any question or if any query, you can put that in the comment section below, and do not forget to subscribe this channel and like this video, and do not forget to share this video with your friends. This is Vivek Choubey signing off. Thank you.